What's up, guys and ladies, and welcome to another episode of the Triple C Podcast. Tonight's lineup, he's got all your Marvel Legends news, he's rectangular, we got the last dinosaur, Michael Wisman, and holy shit, waking up out of his SDCC coma, we got the DMC, and me, I'm Punker Mike. And the 3C squad, I'd like to give a huge, fatty, warm welcome to our newest podcast member, also a California resident, part of the Toy Amigos They're Not Dolls podcast. His name is Josh Cheney. Welcome to the podcast, man. And tonight's special guest, one of ACBA's most creative and out-of-the-box thinkers, constantly putting out clean and crispy work. In his Denzel voice, he says, Tom Cruise in Cocktail ain't got nothing on me. His name is Muhammad Nurullah.
Yeah, he's got nothing on me. Not a thing. What up, guys?
Another excellent intro, Punker Mike. Thank you. So, yeah, thanks for coming on, Muhammad. And like Punker Mike said, Josh Cheney, otherwise known as Cheney180 on Instagram, is our newest member of the crew. So... Thanks for joining us, Josh.
Oh, thanks for having us. It's completely my honor, gentlemen.
New record for longest intro.
Well, shit, dude, we're rolling deep now. We got people. Damn.
We're gonna have 20 on one episode just to see you try to make it through.
I was struggling.
Next time.
Oh, go ahead. Well, I was going to say the main reason we invited Josh is that, you know, the schedules can sometimes be crazy. And you know, if Punker Mike or Michael Wisman or Diego can't make it to the show, that way it's not just me hanging out with the guest. So it's always good to have an extra member on hand if, you know, somebody wants to... Oh, there's Muhammad.
There he
is. Oh, yeah. That works. So, Muhammad, what part of the country you live in?
I'm in Boston, Massachusetts. Well, technically I'm in Sharon. It's like it's the town right out of Boston. Nice little area.
Yeah, I knew it was Massachusetts somewhere, but I thought you were more like in the north part of the state or something.
Yeah, it was like this the South Shore, Southern Mass. Like I said, I'm like 20 minutes away from Boston. I have there's a whole lot of other ACB artists like within like 15 miles of me. It's pretty cool. Al Figs, Logan Stark, Mark Nolan. Yeah, exactly. Mark Nolan. Yeah, there's a whole bunch around here. Ed Noto, excuse me. I forgot about him.
The Bunch of cool. Jedi. I didn't know Ed lived near you.
Oh yeah, everybody's pretty close to me. It's cool. Got a nice community in our area.
Have you guys all hung out together at any time?
I've only got to meet up with Al before. I've never met Ed or Mark or Logan or any of them. We planned on it, but every time something happens, like the kids, the youngins always have something to do with messing up our meetups.
Yeah.
That's all good, though.
Kids take priority.
Oh, yeah, always. That's what they're for, though.
So, let's see. So, comic conventions, you guys have some good ones around there?
Well, we've got the Boston Comic-Con coming up, I believe. I hope I didn't miss it already. Boston Comic-Con coming up, and there's the Rhode Island Comic-Con. Both of them are really good. Boston Comic Con, it's at the Boston Seaport Center, and that place is gigantic. So it's always good time for Boston Comic Con.
Cool.
It takes like 2 hours, about 2 hours almost to get inside that place, but once you're in there, it's quite the show.
Popping.
Yeah, no, it's crazy. The place is gigantic. they built it a couple of years ago. Well, they revamped it, whatever they did, but it's massive. And I took my son there last year, and yeah, he had a ball.
Cool. He's 5.
Yeah, he's 5. He's 5 years old. All the kid wanted to do was just take a picture with one of the cosplay girls. That was it. That was his mission.
Wow! Already he's.
Yeah! Oh yeah!
Oh yeah!
Yeah. That's why we can't take Todd with us anymore.
Oh shit! Is that Jessica Rabbit? Hold up, guys.
Yeah, that was him the whole time.
Hey, Diego's the one who got to meet or got touched by Alyssa Milano.
That's right.
I thought it was Alyssa. I thought Alyssa Milano came up to him.
She put her hand on top of my hand like she was trying to tell me something.
Yeah. Something important to say.
I said, I'll meet you later after your little... I'll meet you later.
Here's my hotel key.
Take this. You know what to do with it.
Mohammed, have you ever been out to California?
A long time ago. I haven't been out there in probably 20 years almost. I have family out there, but it's been a while since I've had a chance to go visit them all.
Cool.
Nothing's changed, don't worry.
Yeah. It's just hotter and more populated.
Yeah. Yeah, my I have an uncle in Laguna Hills, something like that.
Oh, that's
nice. It's been a long time since I've been there.
That's a nice area.
Yeah, it is.
The last time I went, it was like in the early 90s, so it was still in like the middle of friggin' like gang time. Mm-hmm. So it was not the nicest visit at the time. My cousin was on one side, and we were trying to go to an area with people on another side. So yeah, it was like that.
Yeah, like I said, nothing's changed. So you know, feel free to come back.
Yeah, we just got Al Chang moved back to LA, so I'm looking forward to meeting him in person pretty soon.
Man, he didn't skip the beat either. He jumped right on it, man. He's clearing out Diego's area.
Yeah, he's clearing out my spots. I was like, what the hell, man? Now I got to compete with this guy?
Those are my figures.
Yep, you got to step up your game.
I forget. I'm just going to pre-order it.
Hey, ACBA website, man. They ship quick.
Yeah, I got my shit today.
Yeah, I just got Silk and Hobgoblin today as well.
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah, so anybody who's listening to the podcast doesn't know, go to articulatedcomicbookart.com, and you can order all sorts of action figures, Marvel Legends primarily, but Boog is going to be putting up more and more stuff, you know, and also, you know, you can hit him up and ask him, you know, is there something that you'd like to get that may not be listed, and he'll see if he can hook you up.
I really would like to get one of those Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Army Builder packs through the website.
Yeah, those like a pack of 8?
Yeah.
Does he have them now? He's got them now, right?
Oh yeah, I'm pretty sure that they came in.
Yeah.
Sounds about right. So, Muhammad, you... are most, I think, most well-known for doing shots with Mini-Mates.
Yeah. Mini-Mates have definitely kind of taken over my whole display style recently.
But, yeah, they're really excellent. I'm impressed with the dioramas that you're able to come up with. I saw several of them that had water integrated with them, and like the one we did with Kermit the Frog.
Oh, yeah.
And then you had one with a robot. I'm trying to think of the new Gundam, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. How did you pull that off?
That one, I got before I really even get into it, I gotta give a huge shout out and a thanks to Jeremy Lee. It was because of him that I really started doing like smaller scale things and multi-scale displays. I don't know if you guys can see it, but here's that police car I was talking about earlier.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, no, it's dope, right? working in that like small scale, it's almost easier to build smaller sets and like dioramas for them. So I almost have a working city for mini mates and small scale things. But for the Gundams, I ordered all these teeny tiny little people years ago, and I finally got to start using them with that because they scaled so perfectly. We're working on that small scale. I really enjoy it. Like I said, I can make a for 1/12 scale. To have like a working city, a dock, mountains, it would just be so much to build. But working on this small scale, I can pretty much build whatever I want, diorama-wise or set-wise, without having to put in hours upon hours of effort. It still takes a little while to build this stuff, but it's just on a smaller scale, so it's easier.
Yeah, and the storage is probably a whole lot better once you've got it built.
Mm-hmm. I have so many dioramas for 1/12 scale. It was dominating my entire like toy room, like dominating it. But now that I've kind of moved into a smaller, like a 1/24 scale, the space that I save is so much better than before.
Yeah, we'll start to spend so much money on materials and paint and all that stuff.
Exactly. Yeah, Jeremy Lee did something a while ago. He did it might have been Attack on Titan or a Godzilla display. But after seeing that, I was like, all right, I'm changing my game here. I'm moving into something different.
Yeah, it's refreshing. You know, I pretty much just collect legends, and it even gets tiring just seeing, you know, the same stuff over and over again. So it's nice when people are, you know, like when Dave Johnson does his Masters of the Universe Classics shots, and you do mini mates, and you know, other people doing Gundams or you know, a lot of different scaled stuff. It's always refreshing.
Yeah, I also love Legends, but yeah, same thing. I get a little tired of seeing almost the same stuff sometimes. So I try to mix it up as much as I can.
You guys don't love seeing Hydra guys get thrown around the room every day? I live for that.
I do, but man.
Well, it's frustrating because I've only done one setup with my Hydra. You know, I have eight Hydra soldiers. Well, that's just the new ones, and then I have like six of the old ones, and I've never done a shot with any of my AIM soldiers. I have six of those, so it's like, yeah, you don't you know, you don't want to do the same shit that everybody else has done.
You know what's kind of screwed up? I've never seen a Hydra agent. Never. I've never held one of the figures. I've never seen one in stores. I'm living in the past, though.
Yeah, I think I got about half of mine at retail, and the other half I got online.
I don't know, man. There's still Mandroid Wave out there and shit, so you never know what you'll find.
Yeah. I'm still hoping for to get some someday.
Go to Kmart. They still have them for $25, probably.
Not even. They're that old. They probably marked them up to 32. Kmart does that backwards logic. Oh, shit, it's not selling? Double the price.
Jack it up.
Yeah, make sure you don't clean the aisle either. We want them nice and dusty.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, mine still has... God, I'm trying to remember what wave. They had Baron Zemo for a while. But anyway, speaking of army builders, Josh Cheney, I'm assuming you have a pretty gigantic army builder collection.
Not too bad. I think I got like 7 or 8 of Hydra and 7 or 8 of the AIM soldiers. I'm working on the shield agents right now.
What about hand ninjas?
Hand ninjas? Well, I got a bunch of the 3 3/4 inch hand ninjas from G.I. Joe. I just used them as hand ninjas in a bunch of shots. So I went crazy on those a while back. I do own a shit ton of 3 3/4 inch stormtroopers still.
Nice. No Legends 2-pack hand ninjas?
No, I didn't actually pick those up. Like, I was, when they were out, I just looked at them and I was like, nah, I ain't messing with that. Oddly enough. And then later on, I kicked myself in the ass, but.
So, Muhammad, when did you start seriously collecting figures?
Seriously collecting? Probably 6 years ago or so. It was right after I got married. I've always collected action figures since I was a kid, starting with Transformers, and like the original Power of the Force figures and things like that. But probably in 2010 or so, right after I got married, my wife, she bought me a few of the Robots in Disguise line from the Transformers Prime cartoon. She bought me a Ratchet from that. And I hadn't messed with a good action figure since probably the late 90s. So just, even with a Transformer, just getting to mess with the articulation from that, like that kind of, that changed everything. It blew my mind. I was like, wow, toys have come a long way since the late 90s. Mm-hmm. I just kind of started messing around with that one. I had probably every Transformer from the Generations line and the few previous to that, the few lines previous. I had wall-to-wall Transformers. Collected them till probably about 2013. Then I found out about ACBA, and I just moved out of Transformers after that. Started collecting Legends for a few good years. I sold off almost all the Transformers I had, a lot. I had tons of them. I probably sold just about all of them. Started collecting Legends. Then I got more into ACBA and just started seeing all the different things people were doing with their figures, and it just blew up after that. I started collecting NECA, moved into figure arts, more Legends, other random lines. I collected Mini-Mates during that same period for a while. I had a good amount of them. Sold all of them to get Legends, moved back into all Legends and Black Series, and then as of late, within the past year or two, I started moving into Gundams, Mini-Mates, and all sort of other small-scale things. Like I was saying earlier, I could just make so many more sets for them and display ideas with all the small-scale things. Which has kind of blossomed, and I have no space right now. I have boxes filled with miniature. That's what I'm looking at right now. Like, I got bags upon bags, miniature props, scenes, things for scenes. Yeah, the past 6 years have been a toy and action figure whirlwind.
You got married, you turned to your wife and said, I got you already. Started collecting right afterwards.
Yeah, every time she says something to me, I pull out that Robots in Disguise Ratchet. I'm like, well, it's all your fault, babe. Like, this wouldn't happen if you hadn't got this guy. There wouldn't be toys and displays in every room of the house if you hadn't bought this one figure. So,
I know it's been a while.
Relax.
It's been a while since you... You did a video on YouTube, but I know a couple of times you had your kid. You showed your kids playing with your toys, and yeah. I was thinking, oh man, I'm so glad I don't have a little one around here because I was so paranoid. Like, fortunately, our dogs don't mess with my toys. But I can't imagine, you know, you wake up in the morning like, oh, I know I put the speaker somewhere.
Yeah.
How are they leaving your stuff alone?
They're getting better at it. I haven't done my YouTube show in a while. One of the last episodes I did, the first, like, the intro of the show was just my kids, my nieces and nephews just destroying my action figures, absolutely destroying them. I remember at the end of it, my niece, she snapped a SHF Figure Arts Sailor Moon leg, like, right off. Like, she was bending it like she was a butterfly. I'm across the room, I just see it snap. I'm like, oh, God. God, yeah. I love you, but get the hell out of my house. They're getting better at it. The room where I display everything, it's such a mess right now that I really can't do my displays in there. Kind of got to do them in the family room or something like that. So I usually get one shot, like one chance to like get a display done. Because if I leave it out, it's in the living room. The kids are going to come in the morning and demolish it.
Yeah.
I've lost a lot of cutouts because of my children. That's the only thing that they've ever really done. They like playing with the wax.
They got to start putting some respect on your name, man.
Yeah. My daughter's better about it. She's only two, but she's pretty good about it. She knows how important it is to not mess with it.
So do you have to, like, buy, every time you go to the store, you got to buy them some stuff too, so that they'll leave your stuff alone?
Exactly. Like, I got that when I got a police car earlier today. I grabbed a minivan or a little SUV for my daughter as well, so she can play with this one.
There you go.
She sees it so much that she's more about action figures and things with good articulation than she is with dolls, which I'm pretty happy about. I am not complaining about that.
Man, those dolls are expensive. My daughter I don't know that she's big into them now, but for a while she was big into Monster High dolls, and I can't believe it's like,
yeah, they're priced
15, 20 bucks.
Well, the same price as a Legend. It's not the same price as a Legend.
Yeah, but I don't know. They just they don't have the same construction. You know,
it's all that tailored clothes. You know, have you ever looked at the clothing that they're wearing? All the accessories they come with.
How many do you have, Diego?
We have like a lot of Monster High dolls. We have we have two schools.
You better do some ACBA with those.
I thought about it, but the colors are all like freaking weird and stuff. I almost thought about using like the schools for something, but no, the colors and like they're just like weird.
No, you need to pose those Monster High dolls.
I thought about it one time for a joke, but then I was like, nah. I thought about it before, like for a joke, you know? And I was like, nah, I'm gonna get you too much shit for this. And I was never mind. Yeah, I was like, I'll pass.
You say, are you a brony?
Fuck no. You know, what's funny is my girls don't even like My Little Pony. Like, I tried to get them watching. I was like, hey, look, here's like My Little Pony. And they're like, nah, we don't like it.
Yeah.
So I was like, yeah, it's cool.
My daughter likes it, and she likes the ones that were like humans.
Yeah, they like more of the Equestria girls, but that's about it. But they've got a few of the dolls, but they're not really interested in it to get like all of them.
No, that's the Shopkins right now that they're going crazy for.
Yeah, we're not the Shopkins right now. We got Shopkins up ass all over the place. We pretty much have, I guess, I think they have almost all the series. Is my wife started joining some like Facebook groups. And they've been, she's been trading like crazy. I'm like, shit, you trade more than I do. I'm like, you give me shit for trading. And she's always got packages coming in. And I'm like, what the fuck? You know, so like, yeah, so we almost have like all of them, I think.
Good. Now she can't talk shit about you.
Yeah, but she, yeah, but then she's like, yeah, I've seen the prices of the stuff that you get. I'm like, these are a hell of a lot more cheaper.
So, when I picked up my Comic-Con exclusives, it was too hot to go home that day over by Josh's house, so I went to my grandmother's house to hang out, and a lot of my cousins were there, and they're all into the Shopkins. So I walked in with the big old the raft box, like, hey, come check it out. And like, yeah, whatever. So, like, did your friend see any Shopkins at Comic-Con? Like, dang.
Sure did. Got the exclusive, too.
I was like, yeah, my friend said they're all canceled, so fuck you. little girls.
They're on recall, man. People are dying eating those shit.
I saw someone cosplaying at a Shopkin, and I knocked them down.
They're about your height, too. Better watch out. My grandma walked over too. She's all, it's okay. I think they're cool. The Marvel Legends set. I'm like, Grandma, you're making it worse. Get out of here.
She's all, your dolls are cool, Michael.
Yeah.
Let me see.
Okay.
Let me see. Come show Grandma your monos, mijito.
Yeah.
Todd must have been there. Man. That's how it went down.
He was peeking in the window.
Yeah.
He's like, damn it, I want that set.
I had to throw away those fucking boxes down there. I fucking threw them away. And I'm so glad I did, because there would have been no room in the car for them. We had that much dolls and like exclusives. That shit would not have fit inside the car. Not one box would have fit inside the car.
Damn.
Don't worry, kids. I'll be back to pick you up after I drop off these exclusives.
Seriously, I almost thought about it. I thought about going home like Friday or Saturday night, just driving home like in the middle of the night, so I could drop off all the fucking exclusives and then drive back home. Yeah. I fucking thought about it.
Yeah.
And I should have done that.
Yeah.
It's crazy. I guess somebody posted a picture of. Of people, I guess they rented a fucking U-Haul truck to take home all their fucking Mattel exclusives. But that, you know, that was like a vendor or some shit.
Yeah, because I was like, dude, I thought U-Haul trucks were kind of cheap, dude. They're not.
Yeah.
Not so at all.
Like, yeah.
They get you with that. Oh yeah, it's only $20, you know, for like the first 10 miles or something. Yeah. You know?
Until you drive it off the lot.
Yeah, there I go. $5 a mile.
Yeah, all the people on Facebook that were, you know, someone would post a haul and they had like, you know, 20 of everything or whatever, and all the people that would get pissed off and like, oh my god, why do you need so many and all that kind of shit. It's like, you have no idea how hard it is just to get one set.
Yeah, well, they probably got them, you know, for their friends, probably mostly the hookups. They might have probably flipped a few, you know.
Oh yeah.
I'm sure most of them are like hookups or whatever. And then even if not, I was like, who cares? I'm like, oh my God, like this time of the year is the worst because there's so many people complaining like, oh, or the worst is when they go, oh, how come it has to be a San Diego exclusive? Don't you know there's fucking fans that fucking want that and you make it an exclusive, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, where the fuck were you like 10 years ago when they were making the exclusives and no one fucking gave a shit?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know what I mean? They've been making exclusives like, for a long time now. It's just gotten more popular. I used to be able to go around to every booth and get one exclusive from everybody because there was just so small of an amount. There'd be like maybe 5, 10, maybe 20 exclusives for the whole show. And I would get them all just as like, you know, like a memento. Yeah, like souvenir, memento, whatever. And I would get all of them. And then all of a sudden, boom. Everybody has an exclusive now. Now it's impossible.
Yeah, there's exclusives that you like don't even find out about till after the show.
Yeah, right. That's why sometimes I'll search eBay like after the show to see what I missed. Like what were like the giveaways? You know what I mean, at the booths and at the panels or whatever. Like I'll just to see what kind of giveaways they had.
Yeah, it's crazy. It was kind of disheartening to hear NPR talking when the con was going on. They were
really? It was even on NPR? Sheesh.
Yeah, they were talking about the director of the new Star Trek movie, and oh. They were interviewing him. And the way that they introduce it is SDCC, a pop culture event. You know, it's like, it has nothing, you know, they don't even mention comic books anymore. Like,
it is. Everybody, like, if you've been going for a while now, you know that that's what it is now. It's not a comic book convention. It's a pop culture convention. They can't even say, you know, you can't even say it's a comic book convention.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I noticed they're starting to squeeze all the vendors out now, too, because they put all the video game booths, like, the video game companies put all their stuff towards the other end.
Yeah.
Exhibit hall now, so now all the vendors are starting to get, like, squeezed out.
Yeah, because that used to be that right side used to be all vendors.
Yeah, a lot of people. And now it's like it was the dark side.
Yeah, and that's where you would go to get some breathing room. Because I would go down that way. I'm like, let's go fucking this way because there'll be no one over there because mm-hmm. there'll be mostly comics, you know, and stuff like that. And now it's not because fucking video games took over.
Yep. Did you see Mile High came back this year?
Yeah, I saw that, and wow. I was like, good, because yeah. like, I don't really buy anything from them, because I really don't buy any back issues anymore.
Mm-hmm.
But he's been there, like, forever. I've seen him, like, every year I went, yep. you know, because I know he was saying that he wasn't going to go anymore and stuff. But I was like, dude, this guy's like kind of like a staple of the convention, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I was like, no, you should keep going, you know? Because he says he makes money, he makes more money at the smaller conventions. And I was like, that's fucking sad.
Yeah.
You know?
So, Muhammad, do you read or collect comics?
I do. Not quite as much as I used to. It's kind of more, there's a trade paperback out or a collection or something. I kind of grab those more so now. Just because of space. I don't have anywhere to put my comics anymore. Toys and dioramas have taken over everything.
What books have you collected or that you're big fans of?
The Avengers. It's trade paperback wise. It's always Avengers stuff. So I'm late on a lot of stuff too, reading things. The last big set I got was Age of Ultron, the Age of Ultron set from a little while ago. Back to that. Other than that, the previous to that, it was Civil War and Secret Invasion. But I have all of them, spanning like all the different comic lines, different characters. But my comic shelf is pretty much just filled with all Avengers stuff.
Nice. So speaking of comics, I hear Punker Mike got a pretty sweet come up on a comic book this yesterday, right?
Yep, it was yesterday.
Tell us the story, man.
Come up.
I go a little out of town by where my parents live, and there's like two comic shops. There's like the good comic shop that's like an actual comic shop that I have like a pull list and stuff. I'm friends with the owner. Went there, grabbed my books that, you know, that he's got for me, chit-chatted, and then down the street there's this other comic store that's like a comic book store / like video game store / toy store and like records. They got like, it's kind of like in a college town, so it's like a lot of people go in there and they sell their old games or movies and comics and stuff, but they have new shit and old shit. So it's kind of like swamp meat-ish, but it's like a store. So anyway, I usually just go to see what figs they have. So, you know, I went upstairs, and they have all these back issues. It's fucking hot. So if it's 80 degrees outside, it's like 95 in there. So it's fucking hot. So I usually try to just do like a quick like run. And so they have like this one, you go upstairs and there's like figures and vinyl records, and then there's another one, it's like even higher, it's like the attic, and then that's where they have all like the back issues. And then they have like this wall of like behind plexiglass that they have comics that look like, or they think that are worth money, but some of them are like weird shit, like Buffy and Angel issue number one, and they have a, like stupid shit.
Yeah, that shit ain't worth anything.
Yeah, it ain't worth
our Wildcats with the foil cover.
$100.
Yeah, I have like, that. Weird shit.
And so then I'm looking. I was actually filming stuff for Punker's Pit. You know, I was just like, oh, I'll just do like a walkthrough. So I'm filming the poor expensive plexiglass like wall of fame, and then fucking boom, New Mutants 98. I'm like, what the fuck? So I get kind of closer, and this place is notorious for not knowing what they have. Like, the dude, my comic book store guy, he has a buddy that goes in there and scouts it out. He found Amazing Spider-Man 300 for $2.99 one time, just in one of the back. So,
for
like,
what?
They'll sometimes, huh?
For $3?
For $3.
So, the fuck?
So they'll buy collections, and depending on who's working there, because there's a couple guys, there's got Neck Fuzz. Neck Fuzz is the only guy that knows, like, about stuff. So, like, Neck Fuzz knows, like, all the prices on stuff, but some of the other, like, ponytail rocking dudes, they don't know shit. So then I see fucking, I was like, oh, damn, so I get down, it says $75. And I'm like, fucking $75? Last time I checked, this book's going for, like, $200, maybe not $300 anymore, because I think it's died down a little bit. But I was like, that's at least a $200 book right there.
Yeah.
And then that's when I hit you guys up. I was like, what do you guys think? Shit looked pretty good, and then I went downstairs, and Neckfuzz was down there. I'm like, yo, Neckfuzz, I need this, need a book up there, and then, he goes, pulls it, and he sees it. He goes, which one you need? I was like, oh, New Mutants right there, 98 right there, and then he's just like, oh, okay, oh, you like Deadpool, okay, Deadpool, yeah, that's cool, and then he's like, oh, shit, like, he realized what issue it was, and then he looked at the price, and he's just like, oh, what the, oh man, I don't know who priced this thing, like, oh, man, this is, I was like, yeah, let me see that shit. And then I was like checking it out, and then he's like, "Oh man, I don't know who priced this thing. Man, this was like a $400 book, man. Like, oh man, like he was all salty." And I was like, "Oh man, take it out of the sleeve real quick. I want to see the back cover and the pages." Well, the back cover is just an ad. I'm like, yeah, I know. I want to see it though. Like, I want to see that. Like, what if the back cover's like ripped off or some shit? So then I kind of just looked at it, and I was like, "Yeah, I'm gonna take it." And he was all salty. He's like, "Oh well, I was gonna get it if you weren't gonna get it. I mean, yeah, like I said, I don't know who priced this thing. I mean." And then the whole time he was just mad salty. And then he went to the back, and I can hear him talking to the other guys, like talking to the ponytail guys. They're all kicking each other, they're like in a circle, just kicking each other in the dicks.
Now, if I'm not mistaken, that's the first appearance of Deadpool, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's, I mean, with the movie just coming out and Deadpool 2 coming out, that's going to be worth a mint.
So then I went back up the street to my dude. And he was helping some guy, and I'm like, yo, man, look what I just came up on right now. He fucking shit his dick off, dude. He's like, what the fuck? He's like, you paid $75 for that? I was like, at the swap meet? I'm like, yeah, dude, at the fucking the flea market down the street. And he's just like, dang. So I was like, so he's pretty good about comics and shit, because he's worked at a comic book store for a long time. So I had him do, like, a quick grade, and he gave it a 9.4. So I was like, tight.
Then
he kind of gave me, like, what he would go for. He made an offer, but I was like, I'm going to put it on ice for a little bit. Use it as trade bait, or just maybe just keep it in my collection, or save it for a rainy day, or something. But yeah, he's like, man, what else did they got? What else they got? I showed him the video because they had some like old, they had some old issues of Fantastic Four, like some of the first issues, but they were pretty beat up. But they weren't at a price where he could get them and like flip them like real easy. Like they had Fantastic Four number 11. They had Tales to Astonish 60, which that's not that good. Fantastic Four number 9. Where's the? There's another one that they have for like $400 that he thought. Fantastic Four number 6. But they're all a little beat up, and he kind of checked it out, and they weren't worth buying to flip. So he's like, man, you got the fucking fattiest come up ever.
Definitely.
How much was he offering to buy it from you off?
$150, because he's going to just go around and sell it. He's like, well, be honest, I'll give you $150 for it, and I'm just going to sell it and probably make, like, you know, maybe, like, $50 to $100 off it.
Damn.
I think I bought that issue for $1.50.
You bought it right off the rack?
Yeah.
That's because Dean and Diego are old.
It sucks because I have a couple issues. I have a couple issues before and after that I got when I was younger.
Oh,
so,
shit.
So, like, I would, like, go to the swap meet, or we'd go to, like, I think that's when you could buy comics like at like 7-Eleven or like liquor stores or like random places or like just the newsstand, and like I would just pick just random shit up, or people would buy me shit. So I was like, dang, dude, what would be the chances if I would, that'd be one of the one random ones I grabbed.
Yeah, I was like during the highlight when I was totally into comics. That's when Liefeld was on New Mutants right before X-Force, and Jim Lee was on X-Men, and Farmer was on Spider-Man. That's when fucking that shit was on fire.
Nerds.
Good old days.
What are some of not just comic books, but I guess figures are probably more relevant come-ups that you've been able to snag, Muhammad?
Oh, I just finally got two Nick Furies the other day. I've been waiting on those for a little while. My area gets figures, but it's I don't know. It's weird sometimes. Like right now, I'm just seeing the Giant Man wave around. I grabbed a Black Panther. I grabbed a couple Black Panthers the other day to hook some homies up with. I got some got a couple Black Panthers and Nick Furies the other day. It's weird getting stuff around here. Like sometimes the distribution to our area is good, but other times it's real lax. Finding the Nick Furies, that was a big come up for me. That made my week. I've missed out on getting an Army Builder pack through the Articulated Comic Book Art website. So I've just been searching around. My comic shops have them, but I don't want to pay more than retail price for something like that I want a lot of.
Yeah.
So I grabbed a couple of those the other day. And now that I actually have them in hand, I'm dying for more.
Hit up Bug, man.
Yeah.
Hit him up. Just hit him up. Just be like, next time you get them in stock, man, just give me a ring and I'll pay for them.
Yeah, I PM'd him. I messaged him on Facebook the other day, like saying that. I was like, yeah, man, I got to get one of those packs. I can't be left in the dust.
They calling me, man.
Because like I said, I didn't get I've never seen a Hydra agent. Or an AIM. Like, I've never held them in hand. Like, just getting the S.H.I.E.L.D. guys, I was like, I am not missing out again. Not at all.
With all those guys in your area, I'm surprised you don't walk into the store and just see John Connor's calling card on the empty pegs or something.
I've been to spots after Logan Stark, you son of a bitch. Like, I've been there, and like, I know Logan was here. I know he was just here. Because there's nothing on the shelf. And I just saw him post in the group that he's got a million of them. Yeah. I knew he was here.
That's Diego now with Al Chang. Mm-hmm. Diego's like, hey, Al, you want to go hunting today? Nah, I already got everything, bro. There's a white tiger got all the stores for you.
What's that?
There's a lot of those around here. White Tigers, Misty Knight, and Spider Woman or whatever the hell that girl's name is. They're everywhere, all over the shelves. It's all we got. I was talking to a few guys in another group last night. I bartend, so I'm always out of work at like 1 in the morning. Like I drink so much soda and crap at work. I'm always wired when I leave. I'm like, come on, somebody talk me out of going to Walmart tonight, so I don't waste my time looking at Misty Knights and friggin' speedsters.
Yeah.
Even whatever his name is.
Man, there's still, like, Kmart still has a Hawkeye and an Iron Fist. Man, those things are collecting so much dust.
And Sentry. I'm really tired of going out in the middle of the night and finding 36 Sentries on all the pegs. I have in mind to just buy them up.
Speaking of come-ups, how about you, Josh Chaney? Any awesome deals that you've been able to snag?
I found that Toys R Us 3-pack with Sandcap and K. Bishop, Hawkeye, and Vision this morning at Toys R Us. It's really cool because the manager, I'll walk in the morning when they open up, and he's like, what are you looking for? And I'll tell him what I'm looking for, and he's like, all right, and he goes back and he looks just to make sure they, like, you know, it's not just sitting in the back.
What the hell?
Richmond's like, dude, I walk in there, he's like, get out.
Yeah.
You have to have a kid with you. If you don't have a kid with you, you have to get out. Call the cops.
Yeah, he always, like, I always go with my daughter because, like, I always just take her with me in the morning on Saturday. And so, like, I roll in with the stroller because she's, like, two. So I just roll in, and, like, the ladies that work there are like, oh, hi. And she waves at them.
Like, here comes that guy in that ACBA shirt again.
Yeah. Yeah, Chaney is Michael Wisman's nemesis, like Al Chang is Diego's.
I know, Michael's rolling around on the ground right now pulling out his hair hearing that story. VIP treatment.
They rolled out the carpet for him. I try to walk up, and they just shut the door right on me.
It's like 10:05. They're like, yeah, we'll open up a bit. Josh rolls up. Oh, come in. You're going to have to wait, Michael.
I gave him the shipping schedule for Walgreens the other day. I said, all these Walgreens, they'll get the X-Men and whatnot on these days and whatnot. So I try and hook him up as much as I can.
You know what? I should have taken a picture, but the other day I was at Target here, and someone did leave a business card on the Star Wars pegs, and it was to their podcast, and I had never heard of it before, so I don't think it's necessarily figure related. I think they might be more of a Star Wars thing, but I wanted to take a picture of that because I still have your stickers and some other shit. I might just start dropping that inside packages at Target.
Oh, yeah. That'd be cool.
That'd be tight.
We need triple C.
There you go. Yeah, make some triple C stickers and slide them in there.
Yeah, where you at, Todd? Where you at on that sticker connect? Mm-hmm. You got Wisman the artist right here.
Let's see.
Wisman used to make stickers for a living.
They don't let me in the stores, though.
Yeah, we've joked in the past about managers at Target have a picture of Michael's. Do not sell to this man.
Dude, I told my wife to go in there the other day with the baby and like hit him up for that X-Men thing, and they said they weren't in stock, and like she asked, and they're like, no, we don't have them. And I was like, what the hell?
They're liars. Man, don't bullshit me.
Yeah.
Total liars.
Yeah, so what did you did you actually go through when you got yours? Like, what did you find? Well, like, what finally worked, Todd?
He was crying.
Give me the toys, please.
Do you know who I am?
I have terminal cancer.
Ouch.
They're like, fuck, dude, just get this guy out of here. You pull the cancer card, bro, get him out.
My mutation disease.
Oh, here comes that guy with the sandals again.
Yeah. Yeah, I already called the cop sevens.
I'm going to dial 9-1, and if he asks again, you dial the other one.
I went to two different Targets. The one I went to twice in the same day, and it was only like an hour or two apart, so it was pretty much the same staff, and got shut down twice, and went to the other Target, and I knew they had them, but the guy, he went in the back, and whoever he talked to just said, just tell that guy we don't have them. So I came up, he just shot me down. So then. Then I went to my Target again, like the next day, and again in the afternoon after I got off work, and got shot down. And then finally, I went to work, or on my way to work. I think I was on. I was on Wednesday because they kept saying that they were going to reset the aisle on Wednesday. So I went there right after they opened, and I talked to this older lady who's been there a long time, and she's pulled stuff for me in the past. In fact. She was the one who pulled that the first time. I was like the first person in the community to get that. I always forget the Mandroid Wave.
No, Ironmonger.
I know, I always get that wrong. Ironmonger. The Ironmonger Wave. And she's always helped me in the past. So I was like, okay, cool. I know I can get her. So I got her to go in the back, and she. Finally brought him out, and because she said everything is on pallets, and she didn't know which location, you know, because they had them, they actually had them labeled by the aisle, but she didn't know which aisle they were in. So the manager was back there, and I was like, oh, great. You know, the manager's going to tell her, no, you can't get them until the 31st, because that's what they kept telling me. And the manager actually helped her say, oh, you need to go to this pallet. And then she pulled them for me, and you know, I grabbed the four that I wanted. So, yeah, and then, what the hell? Yeah, and then I just, yeah, I've got them all on pre-order, but I just want to, you know, try to swap out the ones with the worst paint apps at the store. That's always what I do, compare them with whatever ones I get online. I just got to wait 90 days, or I have 90 days for the damn things to get here before my receipt expires.
Hustling, man.
Yeah, you gotta, if you get shot down by one crew of employees, just wait until the shift changes.
Yeah.
For the stone kid wearing the ICP shirt.
Yeah.
Talking about homies.
And I'm just checking inventory now, and it looks like one of the stores yesterday that had a full case, now they're missing two, so I'm guessing that's going to be Deadpool and Wolverine.
Yeah.
That's funny, because I did the Brick Seek, and I checked the targets in my area, and they all had them, and they were all missing two.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're going to see that a lot.
Now, the problem now is that so many employees are scalpers, so even if they don't collect the shit, they'll, you know, they're like, oh, well, let's see what's in here, and they'll check eBay, and then you're screwed.
Dude, I was at Target. There was one by my work, like, I think it was, like, last year, around Christmas time, like, when, I think it was, like, the three-packs were coming out with the, what was it, the Hulk?
What came Hulk, in? Vision, and, Ultron or something?
Yeah, I think it was that one. And they'd had them in the back, and so I asked one of the guys, I said, hey, can you go back there and, you know, check it out? Or no, I asked one of the ladies, and the guy that worked in the video game area, he came like running up all quick style, and he's just like, he's like, oh, I'll go look. And she's like, oh, okay. And he like walks back there, comes back, he's all, no, they're not back there. And I was like, it says you got them on hand, like we're, you know. And so like he's like, no, I couldn't find them. And I'm like, you're a liar, man.
Yeah, you're full of shit.
Yeah, so I went back the next day, and I had a different lady come. And so she's looking back there, and she's like, and there was one missing by then. Like, it said they had, like, one less on hand. And, like, she looks back there and, like, you know, pulls them out, and there's, like, one missing already. I was like, what the hell? Like, obviously that's what happened. He's like, no, no, no. Like, it's hard to find anything at that Target, man. I think that guy, like, pretty much, like, holds it down over there because he works there.
Oh, yeah. Now, I'm going to give you a little secret. Well, all of our listeners. So a lot of people, I'll publish a news video, especially like when I get UPC numbers, and so many people are, you know, they turn their nose up and they're like, you know, UPCs, who cares? You know, why is that important? And they have a different story when the damn wave hits, because then they're like, oh, I need the UPC, and you know, help me out. And one of the things you can do, especially if you get an employee like that who doesn't want to help you, and you don't want to, you know, show them your phone, what you can do is bring up one of the UPCs for the figures in that wave that you're looking for.
Mm-hmm.
And you go online, and you can use a UPC, or I'm sorry, a barcode generator, and you plug that UPC into a barcode generator, and it'll let you know, create a barcode which you can you know, save to your phone, or you can just, you know, use the online version on your browser on your phone. You use the price scanner that is attached to the wall there. So if they if they try to pull this bullshit about, oh, it's not in stock, you say, oh, really? And then you just scan your phone into the price scanner, and it'll pull it up. And it'll show the DPI, and it'll show the stock of what they have available.
Yeah, for that specific figure, right?
Well, all the figures for that, the only problem is that if it's a Captain America wave or a Spider-Man wave, if they have any inventory of any of those older waves, it's going to, because the DPCI is the same.
Right.
Now, it'll work great right now for the X-Men wave because it's a brand new DPCI. It's not associated with the Captain America or Spider-Man or Guardians of the Galaxy or whatever. You know, you typically one wave per year will get a unique DPCI. That, you know, it has to be a non-Captain America / Avengers. It has to be a non-Spider-Man wave. Yeah. So, like, the X-Men wave, it's got a new DPCI. The years before, it was the Guardians wave. The Doctor Strange wave will probably get its own DPCI, I'm assuming. Or they'll just tie it into the X-Men wave. But more likely, I'm thinking that it'll probably be a new DPCI for the Doctor Strange waves. Especially since it's...
What's the consensus on on-hand quantity versus saleable quantity?
I understand how that is now.
Okay.
So, on-hand quantity is, at least for me, is legit. It's very rare that I see that number. It's usually off by maybe one, just because their system doesn't always update immediately. But the saleable quantity means how much space they have on the shelf to accommodate those.
Ah.
So if normally they only put out, like, if the peg will only hold six figures, it's going to say saleable quantity six, because they only allocate one peg for that wave.
Good to know.
Yeah, that is.
So don't really pay attention to what saleable quantity is. It's kind of just bullshit. Just
concentrate. Josh, we're in luck because all of our targets have X-Men wave at 8.
Ooh. That's going to be a good morning tomorrow then.
Yeah. And all of them have the Civil War 3-pack at 4.
Yeah, I saw that at Toys R Us this morning, but I chose the other one. I guess they got him in last week, the Civil War 3-pack. It's funny because I got the Toys R Us 3-pack with Sam Cap, and like there's like all these guys there that, you know, they'll go in the morning. They're like, I'm pretty sure they're scalpers because like they're like swarming all over me. Like, oh, what did you get? What did you get? Like, oh, I just got this, and one of them was like, oh, that's just Marvel stuff, and he like walked off, and I'm like, okay.
Yeah, scalper status.
And then another guy's like, oh, are you getting all of them? And I'm like, no, I'm just getting one, man. So he like grabs two of them and just like books it out. I was like, oh, all
right. What did he grab?
He grabbed the 3-pack. He grabbed like two of them.
Oh. Man. So now that we're on the discussion of Marvel Legends, I have a theory that there is one factory that has the best quality control, and typically they save that factory for the exclusives. But this year, I think that they used that factory for the X-Men wave.
I can agree with that. That makes sense.
Yeah.
Because
the set I got was good.
Yeah, the exclusives were not that great. I mean, the set that I got was, you know, decent. And, you know, the guy who helped me get them, you know, did the best he could to, you know, get, you know, best looking figures, even kit bashed my Enchantress. And even then, you know, she had issues. Whereas, in years past, very few, I mean, the Hela, which has tons of paint detail, I have two of them, and They're almost perfect, both of them.
Yeah, mine's jacked up. It came with, like, they painted the paint on the wrong side of the arm. Like, I think on the left arm. Like, the, you know how it has, like, the green circle on the front?
You're talking about on Hela or Enchantress?
On Hela. Uh-huh. Yeah, from last year. It was on the back instead of the front. And I was like, what the hell? But other than that, it's dude, it looks great. Like, the, you know, all the paint on all the figures, on the faces and everything looked, like, really good.
Are you sure you just didn't rotate that that shoulder joint?
No, that's what I thought, too. I thought I had it, like, upside down, but, like, the way that the joint is, like, that shoulder joint, like, you know how it, like, goes up, like, so far? And I tried to flip it around, and, like, it wouldn't go down all the way because it was, you know, they painted it on the wrong side, or they put two right shoulders on it.
Yeah, you know how messed up his exclusives were? Hela.
Yeah, but the man, I haven't busted them out of the package, but those X-Men figures that are, they look fantastic. It looks like they finally spent some money. You know, the females have like very convincing looking makeup on and stuff.
So dude, the Kitty Pryde is probably like some of the best like paint work on the face that they've ever done. Like,
yeah, it's great.
Rogue looks amazing too.
Yeah, Rogue looks really nice too. I like on the Enchantress from the SDCC pack, she's got actual, like, what is that, eyeshadow?
Mm-hmm.
I was like, oh wow, they like added that on. Like, that's pretty neat. So we don't usually get that.
You guys see Craig Warwick kind of paint up his Iceman?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That should look nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, it doesn't look super hard to do either. I mean, you basically just dry brush some white on it.
Yeah, I know on the shitty Iceman from the X-Men 5-pack, I just did like a blue wash on that one, and it made it look a lot better. I mean, it still looks like a piece of shit, but it made it look a little bit better.
Yeah, Iceman is the worst.
Dude, oh my god. I don't know what the hell happened with that pack. Like, it had so much promise, and they just... Man, I don't even know. Like, they dropped the ball. They dropped like the whole house on that one.
Right after I got that set, I was like, "What? I was like, Why did I really just waste money on this?"
Gotta hope you got it on clearance.
No, yeah, I had a friend hook it up, but I was like, "Man, I love these costumes, but these figures are just fucking hot garbage."
I'd love to see him go back and do that set again, but use like the new teenage body for all the X-Men. You could probably use the same
thing,
but it'd be nice to see them use that new teenage body that Miles and Peter Parker is on to do like Cyclops and Angel and Iceman.
Yeah, don't hold your breath, but
well, I'm just wishful thinking is all, you know. It'd be nice to see them do that.
Yeah, there's so many figures, even since Hasbro rebooted Legends, that they need to go back and redo, like Madam Hydra.
Mm-hmm. Oh my
God, all those figures that don't have ankle pivot, like, what the hell is his name? The dude who's, I mean, we're probably going to get a movie version once the Black Panther movie comes out.
Claw.
God, that Claw is a horrible figure.
Constrictor. Yeah,
I would want a Madam Mask because we actually have a lot of characters that go with her now.
I was about to say the same thing. I was playing with the older Madam Mask the other day, just swapping heads on that body, and the head's so tiny on it, like you can't do anything with it.
Yeah.
And Punker Mike made a really good point. I think in his latest video, talking about the soft plastic on that new Iceman from the Juggernaut wave, there's no reason why they can't make the female hair out of that same soft, you know, almost like rubber material.
Yeah, that would do wonders to be able to like articulate the heads a little bit on them damn female figures.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, did you guys see my? the hair mod I did on Mockingbird.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and that material, you know, that's I'm trying to remember, that's Icons, the head that I got it from. I can't remember which DC figure it is, but you know, that's basically a rubber-like material. There's no reason why they can't use the same shit.
Yeah.
Just don't go overboard like the magic figures. They just fall apart.
Yeah.
Yeah, those things do just crumble to pieces.
Yeah. Almost instantly.
Yeah, I bought a whole bunch of them on clearance, just like used in different setups, so like villains or like random magical people. But yeah, you take them out, they just crumble to bits.
Yep.
That crappy plastic they use.
It's weird because the engineering of like the articulation is actually pretty nice. It's just the quality of everything is bare minimum.
Yeah. Like that lion guy, whatever his name is, that white lion looking guy. His the articulation in his legs is awesome. It's like that, this weird backwards bend, but then it still straightens out fully, and it makes him so much taller. But whenever you're messing with it, you feel like you're gonna snap the legs in half.
Yeah, I had one of the females. Fortunately, I just bought her for fodder to Kip Asher, but the torso joint snapped. otherwise, I was aware of how fragile they were, so I didn't mess with them too much. But Funko, they better step it up.
About figures.
What's that?
So they don't know nothing about figures. If it ain't a bobblehead, they don't put their big teams on it.
Yeah. They dropped it hard. They dropped the ball pretty bad on those Fallout figures. Especially the Vault Wanderer figure. That thing's just a poorly engineered mess.
Yeah, they did the same. That was basically any of those legacy figures. The what the hell? Is that Firefly? Yeah, those things. Brutal as fuck.
You know, I never ended up getting him, but does anyone have the rock?
Oh, you just mean...
I never got one.
What'd you say, Michael?
The Rocketeer. From, I think it was them that made it.
Yeah, it was a Funko Legacy.
I almost got it, but I don't know, I had a feeling, I was like, this shit's going to fall apart on me.
Yeah, with your luck, definitely.
I wouldn't even open the box, and it would just start rattling around immediately when I pick it up.
That's if we could get in the store to get it.
Yeah.
They said, excuse me, sir, can you step aside? Hey, Josh, did you need any Rocketeers before I throw these out?
Let me get rid of these. You want any of these? Well, I don't know.
I'll take them. Sir, that's going to be $29.99 for you.
Lock the doors.
So, Muhammad, what figure's coming out this year are you most looking forward to?
Honestly, right now, there's not a ton on my watch list right now. Cause like I was saying before, I'm some random sometimes with the figures I'm looking for. There's a few Minimate sets coming out that I'm still trying to grab. Mostly like the rest of the Muppets and things like that. But big wise, there's not too much I'm waiting on right now. I'm trying to like rack my brain. I'm like, there's nothing really coming up that I'm super psyched about.
Nothing from that Doctor Strange waiver excited for?
Not too much. which is crazy. That Spider-Man wave, I wouldn't mind a Miles Morales and the new teenage Spider-Man. That's kind of about it right now. Namor, Oh, that Punisher. now everything's coming out. The Walgreens exclusive Punisher. That's one thing that I definitely want. I want a couple of those if I can.
Yeah, for modifications
and customization.
Hopefully it'll be as plentiful as the Namor.
I just can't wait to get that Punisher so I can put that Greco head on a suited body.
Yeah,
I went to Walgreens the other day trying to get a Namor. Like, I looked online and it said that they had six of them, and back to employees not wanting to do anything. I'm asking the two girls at the register. I'm like, yeah, could you maybe go in the back and check and see if you have those? Nah, we ain't got them. They, excuse me? Nah, we ain't got them. So it says on your website that you have six. Nope, we don't got them. Got to talk to your manager a minute. I asked him if he could go in the back and grab them. We're about to close up. I'm going to do the registers. I don't know if we're going to be able to check for those right now. Ah, what the hell?
Damn.
I know you got them back there, but you guys are being really, really lazy right now.
Dang.
Nah, man, you got to go in there big dick swinging. Let them know.
Yeah.
They hit you with that pop copy shit.
Yeah, exactly. I'm your manager.
Shit, you talk to the other guy, then I know, I don't know him. Maybe you can help me out with that one.
Yeah, no, they see me coming from a mile away. Like, oh, here comes that guy with the Transformers shirt. Put all the action figures away.
Throw them away. Just throw them in the baler.
Yeah.
Quick, lock the. Oh, hello, sir. Welcome.
Yeah, who's that old man walking around with the Adventure Time hat on? Looks like a creep. Right.
Hey, man, you guys are open 24/7. Not today, man.
Yeah, not today. We close at 7.
We voted and we're all taking lunch for the next hour.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got action figures here. Nope. We sell spaghetti.
The website still has them listed, so if you order 2, you get free shipping.
Mm-hmm.
Just saying.
Yeah, you usually end up going that route.
Yeah, I know the Walgreens around here, they've been, like, holding them in the back because for some reason they think that the X-Men wave is, like, an exclusive to their store. So, like, you have to ask the employees to bring them out.
Yeah. They were doing that with the Black Ant around here for a while, that Ant-Man. They had all of them in the back with, like, security things on them. I'm like, you guys have 75 of these things. You don't need to keep them in the back locked up. Nobody wants them.
Yeah, all the stores.
Maybe if you put them out and somebody steals a few, you might make something.
All the stores in my area are showing six to ten in stock. Oh, I'm sorry. One store says 2 to 5.
Yeah, they're pretty plentiful. We need you to tighten up those estimates there, Tom.
Yeah, I was saying in my last haul video, Diego was nice enough to snag a couple for me, and then the next day, they had the whole case.
And y'all, nah, Diego, I'm good. See ya.
Yeah.
It's already in the mail. Nah, I'll take the refund now.
You better track down that postman. I mean.
I told him, I was like, before you buy it, make sure you hold on to the receipt, because I know I'm going to find it.
What the hell?
I mean, that's always how it goes.
Yeah. Speaking of Diego doing shopping, bro, you gonna get some of those shopping carts, Diego, or what?
He must have fallen asleep.
Oh, man, those carts. No,
he's got his mic muted.
Oh, well, if you're talking, Diego, unmute yourself.
Yeah, I've been trying to get those shopping carts, but they're the only place I can get them is just, like, from overseas. And they have, like, so many different styles. They have, like, 4 different styles of them. I'm just like, man, I don't want to get the wonky-ass ones.
I showed my wife those earlier. I was freaking out when I saw that post. I was like, oh, them little shopping carts for $1.99?
Because I seen them at Hobby Lobby, and they were, like, $7. I was like, nah. I was like, I'll wait till I see them somewhere.
They're not too big?
Nah, they look all right.
They look big.
They might be a little on the big side.
Mm-mm.
But they're not too bad.
No, that work with wrestling figures.
Did you guys see that post of those articulated animals?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
$400.
Yeah, the price, though, that was out of control.
I was like, whoa, because I saw the picture. I was like, oh, yeah, those are bad articulated animals. I'm down with that. And I looked at the price. I was like, holy shit.
How much were they?
$350.
Just for one? Expensive.
You can get real animals. You can get like two real animals for that. I can get a used dog for that.
Used? Punker Mike would get a dog for cheap and have his guy graded at a 9.4.
My much friend hit me up. Hey, man, I'm about to get this dog. He's showing me pictures. Hey, man, he wants this much for it. I was all, man, you're going to pay that much for a used dog? He looked all sad after I said that. I was like, hey, man, I'm bro.
Come up.
Shit, yeah, $350, you get like almost a purebred dog for that.
At least half pure.
Yeah. Quarter half.
That's like that dog from that movie, Half Baked.
Yeah. That we got the dog and the house for $500. It was used.
I know, that's where I got that from.
Yeah, I think we have two purebred dogs. I think one we paid $300 for and the other one $400. So, yeah.
For that price, you get yourself one articulated animal, Todd.
That thing
won't, fool.
That thing won't shit on your shit.
Yeah, exactly. You don't have to clean up after it.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Yeah, it's funny how we were talking, I think we were talking about this on the episode with Boog, that the majority of the people in the community are married, and I'm practically married, so like all of us here, and Punker Mike's going to be married soon.
I'm practically married, dude. I've been with Bree for like 9 years.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Yeah, you're married.
Yeah.
He's engaged.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna crash Punker Mike's wedding.
You guys are invited if you want to come. Taco bar. Oh, I'm just saying, taco bar.
Hell yeah.
I might have to make a trip.
Do it. I dare
Punker
you.
Mike's gonna be like Dave or James Franco from This Is the End.
I never seen that movie. I could be James Franco from Pineapple Express.
That's basically the same. Yeah.
That's pretty much as James Franco then. No.
Yeah. In-N-Out truck is coming in 10 minutes. Yeah.
I thought we were gonna hang out and watch weird shit on the internet.
Hey man, I can't even light this thing on my own.
I was talking about that movie earlier.
Fucking Lingers, man. Fucking Kyle, man.
So you guys, any of you guys excited about any of the trailers that they showed at SDCC?
I'm going to watch trailers, Todd.
Today, because I was watching Hollywood Babylon on YouTube, which is Kevin Smith and Ralph Garman podcast, and
whoa, spoiler alert.
Okay. they're talking about the Justice, though. They showed the Justice League trailer, and I was like, oh, fuck it, I'll watch it, because you know, I'm not big into DC. They're raving about how it, you know, they say most of the DC movies suck, but this actually looks pretty good, and they also, you know, they talked about the Wonder Woman trailer, which I watched just a little bit of it, and once I saw how good it was, like, okay, I don't want to watch anymore, because it actually looks pretty good, damn good. So.
Yeah, they're not looking too bad. I never saw Batman versus Superman, but cool. I watched the trailer for Justice League the other day, and I was like, this doesn't look too bad.
Yeah, I just watched Batman versus Superman a couple weeks ago, and it was pretty lackluster.
God awful. Absolutely.
Yeah. The bells are ringing, bro.
Chaney, are you a big DC head?
No, I prefer a lot more Marvel stuff. I think I pretty much just dabble with, like, Batman. Like, I love Batman. I could really give two shits about Superman.
I hate Superman.
Yeah.
I like the Japanese Superman better. Goku's the shit.
Yeah, I don't mess with DBZ, but Superman is just, it's boring. It's like you can only beat him if you have kryptonite.
Yeah.
You don't even need kryptonite. Plus, he's like, he's so old that like they've like retconned him so many times and changed him and done all of that bullshit where it's just like, they've just done everything with the character. Like, they should just kill him for like 10 years. Like, legitimately kill the character and just work on other stuff. Like, have, like, you know, someone else be somewhat of a Superman for a while or something. Like, I loved it in the comics when they killed off Bruce Wayne and had Dick Grayson and Damian Wayne and Robin. That was, like, one of, like, my favorite runs. And even
yeah. The Streets of Gotham, I think, was one of the first titles when it was just the two of them, and I loved that.
Oh, man, that was such a good book. I loved that so much. And then they, like, they brought Bruce back. I was like, why did you do that? This shit was awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I got a quick thing to add right now. The Deadpool's on Bucky Cap, correct?
Mostly, yeah.
Okay, because I was looking at the upper torso, and it's different. Like, I'm checking out U.S. Agent, and U.S. Agent's more cut. Like, he's, like, really cut and, like, defined. Because I messed around, I put Deadpool's head on U.S. Agent, and I tried to put the katanas, but it wasn't fitting. Like, the straps weren't fitting. I'm like, what the fuck? So I was looking at it, and it's, like, his muscles are more cut and deep, and he's just a little bit bigger. So I was wondering if that's because, like, the mold's wearing down, or do you think they, like, kind of modified it a little bit?
Could be the mold.
Yeah, because I don't think it was different, per se.
No, because it looks exactly the same, except for he's just more cut. Like, his titties are a little bit more, like broad, and he's
like
just a little more cut. More broad. He has broad titties.
Oh, okay.
His titties?
Chi-chis?
Yeah.
I took the katanas and the thing off, and I put it on one of the original X-Men bodies, because I was just fucking around, and it fit perfect on there. It looks like it's the same.
Yeah, that's probably why, you know, and you know, Dwight said that at SDCC is that that mold is breaking down.
The katanas are kind of like poking inward like that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, like when I put it on like that, it's like they're kind of like, well, they're kind of straight on the. If I mess with them, they kind of straighten out, but. I don't know, I just thought that was kind of a trip. I was just wondering if, like, yeah, like you were saying before, like how the mold kind of breaks down over time, that's why shit was getting loose, or if they, like, slightly modified it.
Well, if you take, like, the Hydra figure, if you pick up, like, the Hydra soldier or whatnot, like, you can wiggle, like, that torso piece, like, the top where the abdomen back and forth, like, crazy.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, this is what I was talking about. See broad chi-chi? See how broad those fuckers are?
Yeah.
Those are dude.
Todd, can we get a screen grab for the thumbnail there?
You want to touch them?
Yeah, I was complaining to myself about the S.H.I.E.L.D. agents, because their upper torso was real wiggly as well. And like I said before, I've never seen AIM or the Hydra guys, so I didn't know if it was common. But I was ready to take them back to the store. I'm like, these are loose as hell on the top.
Yeah.
Like, there's a nice space between the joint on the ab crunch.
Yeah, that's probably why they are, they came out with that new Spider-Man mold. I mean, they probably won't, like I was telling Boog on the ACBA podcast, they probably won't completely retire the Bucky Cap mold, but they'll start using it a lot more sparingly.
Yeah, they were saying in the panel that they made those two different molds. They made that Spider-Man 2099 one and that UK Spidey one.
It's the same mold.
Well, they said that the 2099 one was more slender than the Spider UK.
Yeah, they look different because the Sunfire also looked like... Wait, no. Yeah, that's his name, right? Sunfire?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, he looked like he was on the 2099 mold, but the UK one looked beefier.
Yeah.
That'll be interesting to see when they come out in hand. But yeah, I think it's great to have, you know, some diversity in the molds.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to those. I'm trying to think of what might be coming out on those in the future. Let's see, that, what the hell is it called? Oh, the Punisher from the Netflix series. I was thinking that they better give us the hood. You know, now that he's got, like, you know, boots and baggy pants,
that'd be perfect.
Yeah, all they have to do is just give him a, you know, they can just cut that same jacket. They can cut that same jacket that Punisher comes with, and then give him a cape with a hood on it. There you go.
That'd be bad to have a red hood figure.
Well, he's just called the Hood. Don't get confused with DC.
Well, he does technically have, a big red hooded cape or whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just that, it's confusing because there's a DC character called the Red Hood.
Yeah.
If they make his cape right, then we might even end up getting a cloak and dagger.
That'd be tight.
That would be cool.
You're closer to finishing my Maximum Carnage team.
Yeah, we need a new Moon Knight as well. I mean, the Moon Knight we have is you know, the Toy Biz one is actually pretty decent. It's on that Bullseye body. Which is still a very good figure, but all those old Toy Biz figures are going to start breaking, like, left and right now.
Yeah, shit, they're old as hell.
Yeah, I haven't messed with one of my Toy Biz Legends in a long time, just because of that.
Yeah, people better start opening them shits, man. You leave them in there too long.
Yeah.
Start disintegrating and fucking eating itself alive.
It's got its own ecosystem in there now.
Seriously.
Mm-hmm.
It needs oxygen. Those old clamshell, man, those shits are sealed.
Yep.
I got a bullseye that's turning blue.
Breaking case of emergency, man.
His little hand, like, came up to the window. There's little scratch marks.
Little individual fingers.
He scratched in.
Let me out.
I'd be like, I don't know, Bullseye. I mean, I can get you for $12 still mint on card, but one of these days, your price is going to jack up.
He's going to use those articulated fingers to flip you off. We need a new fucking Mandarin really bad, too.
Who, Trevor?
Fuck that shit.
Todd's favorite installment of the MCU.
You know, it's crazy. Yeah. Even if you take the robe off of the Toy Biz Mandarin, his legs are just stuck in this. His crotch piece is so wide, like you can't put his legs close together. I mean, he stands with his legs spread, you know.
That's what she said.
That's stupid. I'm glad they didn't use this mold.
I can relate.
Anybody else? I mean, he actually has really good articulation, but that crotch is so wide.
Not to the point where they're rushing all those face-off ones, though.
Mm-hmm. I mean, some of them are amazing. Like the face-off cap is still one of the few Toy Biz Legends worth keeping.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I still really like that figure. I never picked up the Hulk. I saw that Hulk so many times, and it really looks like an awesome figure, but I never picked it up.
You can have the Angry Face version, which is it's a fantastic figure. It's funny, until you really start doing ACBA, you don't realize, like, how many different versions that you need. Like, how many, I just need one Hulk and I'm good. Like, no.
Oh, yeah.
You gotta have, because some of them, you know, like the the face-off Hulk can't make fists. You know, he's got the articulated fingers, but they make his paddle hands. So you can have him slapping somebody, but
yeah.
So
he ain't smashing nothing.
Hulk slap.
And no ab crunch.
Gonna palm you to death.
He's gonna button mash your shit. Fucking button mashing Hulk, hell yeah. Well, one of the older stop motion videos I did in an arcade, and I made a custom poster that said no button mashing, and I photoshopped a picture of E. Honda like button mashing like crazy. I was all proud of that. Still am.
So you guys have any questions for Muhammad?
Yeah, when's little Carl gonna get into some more mischief? Is that little son of a bitch still in house arrest or what?
Yeah, I gotta get that little guy out. My little ACBA kid.
Hell yeah. ACBA kid's tight.
I just grabbed a bunch of little bicycles offline the other day. So I got a few punk kid ideas lined up. And now that I got that Minimates scale police car, the kids are gonna be getting in trouble soon.
I've got a couple different police cars. They're hard to come by, especially in 1/12 scale.
Yeah, and they're expensive.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I got a couple of like the one. I don't know what's those like those Maisto cars. Like, don't they come in like 1/24 scale or something? Is it like that? Like the main size they come in, like those collectible cars?
Yeah, most of them are 1/24 or 1/40 something.
They always have at Costco once a year around Christmas time. They get like two pallets in of all kinds of different cars. And those cars, I think, usually go for like 20 or 24 bucks. They have them there for like $12. And I got a couple cop cars. I got like the old school, like Dick Tracy, like the Mashy, like those kind of cars. Cop cars. I got a couple of those, and then I got a couple of just like the regular cop cars. But they had like different, they had like a 2006, a 1998, and then they had like the 1930 something or 1940s. But they definitely have like an MSD.
Oh, yeah. I got a 1999 Crown Victoria.
God remembers running from those back in the day.
Yeah, right. This was in my heyday.
My dad used to have a big old Oldsmobile. I can't remember which one, but my stepsister brought it home. She got in a fender bender. I remember that was a huge drama. My dad always had huge banker cars. You know, he was a banker, so he always had huge boats until I got into high school, and then. He got a Toyota Celica. He must have been trying to relive his... he's having a midlife crisis. So where do you end up buying a lot of stuff like that? Like Minimates, you usually hit up eBay or Toys R Us or what?
eBay or Toys R Us, I hit them up. I was talking to a friend about it the other day. He's like, yeah, man, where do you always get all these props and stuff for Minimates? I'm like, honestly, man, I'm like, I go down the little girls aisle at Toys R Us, but like all the little girl stuff and girl stuff. It's all small scale, like all of it. Like they got the Calico Critters and all that other random little stuff. But it's all teeny tiny little props, and it all works well. These cars, every single one of these cars that I got them at Rite Aid, like a little pharmacy around here. The Welly cars, they're $9. They're all die-cast metal. They're dope. And a lot of times I can talk the guys into giving me the $4.99 price for them. They have big ones. They have 1/24th ones for $10, and then 1/60th, 1/64th, or something like that for $5. So a lot of times I'm like, oh man, come on, that was on the $4.99 rack. And so some of them don't give a shit, and they just hook it up.
Nice.
Oh. Yeah, I got a nice amount of those now. And the Walking Dead stuff, the Walking Dead building sets. Those props are they're a little bit too small, little bit smaller, but they work with like force perspective and stuff like that.
Isn't that you did a really awesome setup with a camper, like RV camper?
Oh yeah. Yeah, that was a Walking Dead set. Yeah, that was a Walking Dead Dale's RV.
So getting back to the dioramas that you did with water, how did you contain the water? So, I mean, that sounds like it would be a mess.
Yeah, it can be. It was a lot of trial and error for a little while. I was using like cookie sheets and brownie pans for a long time, making a huge mess and pissing my wife off. I was at a pharmacy or something like that, and they have those disposable aluminum baking pans, like the big ones for like turkeys or like crap like that. And I grabbed two of those, glued them together, and it's pretty stable. I had to spray paint it and glue some stuff down, because obviously you can see through the water, and if it's not covered up, you just get this crappy shiny metal glow. Ruins the whole thing. But yeah, I do it all in baking pans, and I've had to put bases on my dioramas to like set them up to be that same size. Because I was putting DVD cases and things like that to hold them up, and then water was leaking out, and I wrecked my copy of Reservoir Dogs. I'm still not over that.
Damn.
Kind of water all leaked out, got inside the case. I was like, man, I gotta figure something out. I gotta stop ruining DVDs here. Kind of stack them. Yeah. You know, it's all in a baking pan, and then I gotta put towels and crap down everywhere. That's another thing that my kids go crazy about. They wake up and they see a baking pan full of water and like a small scale dock next to it. They're like, oh, all right, it's playtime now.
Cannonball!
Exactly.
Come up.
I have a 1/12th scale house. I built it for the world tournament last year. I left it out. I come in here one morning, and like there's no back to it, and my daughter's like sitting inside of it, like she's sitting inside the house. I'm like, yo, what's going on? She's like, living room. I'm like, ah, yes, you're sitting in the living room. You just put a giant 2-year-old butt print in the floor. I'm glad you're having fun, but you gotta get out of there. And that's why I didn't win the world tournament.
Hey, we had to dock you for those butt prints on the floor there.
So how did you find out about ACBA?
it was in a Transformer group. I'm pretty sure it was AJ Frost, I think.
Oh yeah.
He had done a he had done a Starscream shooting at somebody.
With the car, when they're like driving away, getting blasted.
Yeah, exactly. Like a trailbreaker or something like that. It was like going around a corner and like Starscream shooting at him. And I had just started getting into action figure photography at the time, and I saw it. I was blown away. What is this? I looked ACBA up on Instagram. And there was some contest going on at the time. And I want to say it was a display of boobs, but it was G.I. Joe's and something else. I was like, man, this group, they're doing all this crazy shit with Transformers and G.I. Joes and real style cut. I got real displays, real cutouts, no fake effects or anything like that. It blew my mind. When I started, I hate to admit it, but I was messing around with Photoshop and apps and things like that. I looked at it, but it just looks so fake sometimes. And then seeing the cutouts and the real effects, I was like, all right, this is where I need to be. No. I remember I was in another group, and I made a post about it. I was like, oh, man, I was like, this toy photography stuff we're doing is real cool, but I can't wait to someday be on the level of some of these ACBA guys. And they were all, what? I'm like, what's your problem, man? Like, you got a problem with this? I was like, no, not at all. I just think this shit is fucking awesome. And I am all done with these apps and things. I'll keep it real. 80s style. Screw CG. Mm-hmm. I'd rather see a guy in a rubber suit over some computer generated shit any day.
Exactly.
Yeah, there's a lot of toy groups that started up when they couldn't take criticism in ACBA, so.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That was another thing that drew me to it. Like, everybody was real with each other. No pats on the backs or participation awards. I was like, yeah, like, everybody's straight here. Like, I can't remember his name, but the Masters of the Universe guru or something like that. Somebody gave me some real straight feedback on, like, one of my, like, real early shots. And I was like, you know, you're right. I was like, this diorama does look crappy, and my lighting is off. Let me see what I can do about that. Let me try to fix that.
Yeah, it's Motu Guru, who is one of our admins now, Greg.
Oh, yeah.
I think it's Bisneros. I'm not quite sure on how to pronounce his last name, but...
Bresenio?
Bresenio, is that it?
Well, there's Greg Bresenio, but I don't know if he was the same Moto Guru guy.
Pretty sure it's Greg, who's one of our admins, was Moto Guru. Yeah, he had to change. He had to start using his real name when Facebook got all strict about that shit.
Yeah, no, I know Greg now, but I didn't know that was that was him back in the day.
Yeah, I was commenting on your. The picture that you did, the before ACBA and after, the one with the, you had like Batman in kind of an awkward pose, and then you had Kermit as the after.
And, yeah.
And that was, you know, really good advice. You know, you're a perfect example of a person who comes to the group and, you know, has to figure out what it's all about, try to understand what we want to see, and then take constructive criticism and turn around and be one of the best, you know, artists in the group.
Al Figures, he had said something too. He had invited me to Dio Structure, and like, he was really nice about it. And like, in the back of my mind, I'm like, I know he's just telling me that this thing is fucking terrible, and I need to join the group to get my ship.
Yeah,
like, yeah, everybody's straight, and they're not beating around the bush.
Yeah, exactly. You know, we always tell people if you're looking for likes and pats on the backs and appreciation trophies, ACBA is not for you.
Yeah,
like, you know, we're here to constantly be striving to excel the art form, you know, every chance that we can get.
Yeah, and if you're looking to get better, there's no better place to be either.
Nah, there really isn't.
You know, if you're looking to grow and, like, learn and, like, you know, get better at, you know, doing this, like, there's no better place to be. Like, I've learned so much being in the group, and, like, I don't even feel like any of my shit, like, holds a candle to, like, probably, like, 90% of the guys that are doing it. Like, I'm still learning new things, like, every day.
Yep. Constant growth. Like, it's the only way. I can look back at a year worth of photos that I took, and like they're all garbage to me now. Like, this was terrible. Like I said, it's all crap. Like this was all before I knew anything about ACBA. It's all junk. Even now, some of it's still junk.
You're like J. Jonah Jameson going through Spider-Man pics. Crap, crap, more crap.
Yeah, there aren't too many
crap.
People.
I'll give you a couple of mini-mates for him.
Yeah, there are not too many people who like right off the bat are excellent. You know, it's pretty. I mean, there's a few exceptions. People who kind of lurked in the shadows, like Punker Mike and Michael Wisman, who, you know, they were in the group for a while but didn't post anything, and then when they decided to start posting, didn't take them long. You know, like the first couple shots might have been rough, but then very quickly they learned, you know, like, okay, and they went back and tweaked stuff, and then bam, they were like up and running. But not too many of us have that talent.
I don't think I'll ever forget Miguel's World Tournament display from like a year or so ago, the arcade one. I remember I was sitting there watching it, and like I got up off the ground, I was like, holy shit, this is dope.
Oh, from Photo Combat?
Yeah, Photo Combat one. Yeah, Spidey and Deadpool playing an arcade game or something.
Yeah, I've been wanting to redo that one.
Yeah, that was so cool.
I gotta go back and look that up. It's not fresh in my mind. I don't remember that.
Well, you should, Todd. You gave me a shitty score. No. I remember it. No. Yeah, that was my first photo ever that I posted in the group was for photo the first entry to Photo Combat. That was my first contribution.
Nice.
Dang.
Man, you had all, and you then you all your displays. Like after that, you had like all these tiny little props, things that you put together. I was like, man, god damn, I gotta step my shit up. So cool.
You guys have any more questions for Muhammad?
Would you rather fight one horse-sized duck or 100 duck-sized horses?
I was talking about that the other day. Like, man, a horse-sized duck, that shit would kill you. That real.
Oh, yeah, dude. Because ducks already think they're pretty badass. Like, you go to the park,
exactly.
They're fucking like, they're like, who wants some? Yeah. And then especially a horse-sized duck, dude, he would just be wrecking shit, dude. Like, you would think he was, like, the hottest shit ever.
Can you imagine how loud his quack would be? It'd be so deep.
You mean his roar?
Yeah.
Yes, horse, bro.
Quack, quack.
Fucking duck-ass horse.
I mean, if you think about it, dinosaurs were almost just kind of like big duck lizards.
Yeah, they were like big birds almost, huh?
Yeah.
Sure.
Fuck that shit.
I'd have to go with the
duck-sized horses?
Yeah, 100 duck-sized horses.
Start kicking.
I feel like I could come out on top. Yeah.
Oh, you mean like little tiny horses?
Yeah.
That shit would be so funny. They're all jumping around all stupid. Dude, I'll take that. That shit's funny. Chasing them around, dude, that should be so funny.
I don't know.
Grab an apple and run around in a circle. I'm like, oh, come and get it, you dummies.
Yeah, but then they'd be just like dinosaurs too, like the compies, man. You guys would be laughing and they'd overwhelm you at one point.
Yeah, but their bite wouldn't be that bad.
Get it like the guy in Jurassic Park Part 2.
Yep. That's going to be Todd. He's going to be zapping them like, ah, these aren't that bad, and they're going to catch him in the river.
As long as you can find a good-sized stick, you can probably bat most of them away.
Hey, good-sized steaks.
Between kicking them and smacking the stick.
That was not a well-known part of Todd's Army Ranger training, was if he ever found himself in a scenario where he had to fight 100 duck-sized horses. They weren't sure what they were going to encounter over in Where was it? Korea? Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's right. You were in Korea.
Yeah, I was there for years. Like being in jail.
They probably did have duck-sized horses out there, man. You just didn't look hard enough.
We want you ready for anything.
You got little tiny shoelace lassos. You're all getting them. Fucking breaking them bitches.
Let's see which wildlife over there.
Who was it Kim Jong-il at that time?
Yes.
Yeah, you don't know. He could have done anything, man.
Yeah.
He took over about a year, not too long. Actually, no, I think it was only like 6 months before I got there.
He's tense. Fresh. He's eager to make a big impact. He releases the horses.
Well, not even. He was into 1/6 scale, so he's like, I got to make these duck-sized horses, bro.
They had hot toys. They used to drop propaganda from balloons. It's pretty crazy.
What? Like what kind? Like flyers or?
Yeah, they were like little like postcard-sized pieces of paper.
You flew here. We grew here.
Hey, you know what's funny?
Exactly.
Brie was telling me the other day she was over by Target, and there's a piece of paper with the guy's face on it, and it said El Rata del Santa Maria, or something like that. Pretty much, he said it was like the rat of the town, and someone was all salty at this guy, so they printed out pictures of him and called him a rat and just posted him all over town.
What the hell?
Nice.
I was like, tight. Someone's mad salty on this guy. They went out of their way to fucking make a fucking... They photoshopped his picture, wrote the thing, and photocopied it and went around town. That's so tight.
I'm not going to do that to for Josh, man, at Toys R Us. I'm going to start handing out flyers. Like, if you see this guy, he's a known scalper. Don't sell that.
Yeah, that's what Diego's going to do to Al Chang.
If you see... Man buying action figures, please consult your local authorities.
Have you seen this man?
Dude, they had to kick out this scalper guy from around here at Toys R Us. I guess he was like getting into it with like the employees or something. Like they were, he was, because he's like just like a freaking ass. Like he'll like run in and like grab stuff, and like he was getting like all like ornery about the Hot Wheels, I guess. They're like, you gotta like move, and like him and this other dude were like pretty much like hugging the pigs. They're like, no, no. And then finally, like the manager was telling me, he's just like, all right, I'm calling the cops. You gotta leave. I mean, he's been kicked out of there like numerous times already.
Wow.
What are you in here for, man?
Hot Wheels.
Yeah.
doing 5 years for Hot Wheels. Yeah. Talk to the cop.
Hot Wheels.
Yeah, most of the time when I go to like Target really early in the morning trying to snag something, or Toys R Us, it's usually Hot Wheels collectors are the ones that I have to, you know, because I'm sizing up the competition. I'm like, okay, who can I outrun?
Crazy, I've seen like
60-year-old
men like full on sprinting through Target to get to the Hot Wheels.
Yeah, that's me going to the Legends.
Dude, Todd, we need to get you a GoPro, dude. Like the one yeah. That you wear on your chest. And I just want to see you freaking whip out your phone, scan that shit, and just, like, give that guy who won't get you the case, like, a hard time.
Like, you thought you were going to beat me, huh, bitch?
Well, look at this. The guy's like, fuck, dude. Just take my vet, take my red shirt and my khakis and go in the back, dude. I don't give a shit.
What was it? It was Nick Rogers who posted it. He's like, I just wear a red shirt and go in the back. I've done it before.
Yeah, I was about to say that. Has anybody done that?
I've definitely contemplated it.
Red shirt and khakis, bro.
Yeah.
All you need.
I'm starting to get to that point now.
I got a red polo in my closet.
I'm getting to that point now. And you can easily just make some ghetto-ass name badge.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
A cutout.
hit up TyStar.
Yep.
TyStar just mass produced freaking name badges for Toys R Us, Walmart, and Target. We just gotta match the attire.
Man, yeah. That pack will sell out faster than any of the other ones.
Hell yeah.
Start selling ACBA fake target badges.
That'd be tight. Get a walkie.
What are you talking about? I've worked here for years.
You don't recognize me? You don't know Carlos?
Come on, man. You must be new.
They walk back there, they're just all, hey, I thought I told you to get that stuff stocked over there. Like, quit fucking around over here and go stock that shit that I told you to do. And you're just kind of like, all right.
You're all, fuck you, fuck you.
You end up working
the name tag off. Man, fuck this. Rip the name tag in half. I ain't working here no more.
Fuck, I'm not even supposed to be here today.
You know, I did work at an ice cream place for like a day, kind of. Like, my friend, I had two friends that worked there, and they, like, really didn't care, so we kind of just put on aprons and hats, and we were, like, eating ice cream and, like, getting all drunk and smoking weed in the back, and we were just, like, and it got, like, super busy, and they're like, oh, dude, like, we really need help, but I was like, nah, fuck that, so we're, like, sweeping and doing all kinds of crazy shit. It was tired. But needless to say, my friends didn't work there anymore, like, after they, like, looked at the camera footage, and they're like, dude, why is there, like, eight people mobbing around, like, eating ice cream? It was tight.
Man, that'd probably be my luck. I'd try to sneak back there and I end up working a full shift or some shit.
Come home, your wife's all, where the hell have you been? Like, working at Target all day?
Oh, damn, I'm beat.
Yeah.
We got a huge load here.
Oh, damn it.
I was undercover. I didn't want to blow my cover.
Yeah, fuck, we had inventory today, man. Fucking Carlos called in sick again.
Son of a bitch.
Fucking Kyle keeps putting me on stalking. God.
Do your own go backs, Kyle.
Yeah.
I'll be right back.
I had a guy. This was when the World Tournament first started this year, and I was buying that Carl figure. I think it was actually the second version. I don't know, but it was the Carl from Walking Dead. And GameStop had him on sale for like $4 or something. So I was like, yeah, I'll go price match. And I walk up to the front, and they're like, yeah, I don't know about this. It seems too low. Let me call someone over. And it was this guy, and I see him a lot now at our Target, but he must have just been promoted at the time, and he comes over all fucking, you know, big dick swinging.
Puffy.
And, and he comes up and he's like, unfortunately for you, bud, you got bad luck today. I was like, what? Like, what are you talking about? He's like, yeah, you got the one guy that used to also be a manager at GameStop, so I know that sometimes we like to put this price, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, what the fuck? What are you even talking about?
Who the hell is this guy?
Yeah, and he's like, yeah, so I can't do this for you, bud, because, you know, I used to be the manager there as well, so. And I was like, oh, fuck, well, do you guys price match Amazon? Yeah. I'm like, okay, good, because they got it for $5, asshole.
Yeah, well, I also worked at Amazon.
I also managed a warehouse, so. Now, he got real salty, though. Like, he had to price match at the 5 because I set him up. I was like, yeah, you price match there? Yeah, of course. Oh, perfect. And, he's always salty.
He's still salty on that.
Yeah, I see him a lot of times now, because he's, like, I don't know what he's manager of there, because he's always in, like, certain areas, but, yeah, he don't like me.
Dang, dude, you just got some mad history with Target, bro.
I love Target, too. I don't know. It's just the employees.
When I stayed with you, we went there, like, 3 times.
Hell yeah. I was like, man, I fucking love Target. And they just see me, hey, fuck you, Michael. Oh, yeah, sure. Target's the best.
Yo, can I help you? Nah, just cruising.
Yeah. Just doing my local 4 o'clock. And I'm, you know, I'll make my laps.
Yo, where's Kyle? I'll do his go-backs if you want.
Yeah, as soon as I walk into the front, you guys got any go-backs while I'm doing my laps?
I'll put this stuff away. I'm down.
Yeah. Excuse me.
Yeah. You guys are all West Coast?
Yeah. All California.
Toasty.
Like
10 o'clock there, something like that, 11 o'clock?
10:30.
Yeah. It's been hot as fuck out here, too.
Yeah.
So our cameras are off, we're all sweating. Yeah.
Seriously, dude.
Yeah.
I'm in my chones right now, bro, dripping. Yeah. I'm in a kiddie pool, dude, just catching all my sweat.
No.
It's pretty hot and humid in Massachusetts, isn't it?
Yeah, it's bad. I normally would have been in my room, but like I had to come in the living room and just crank the AC because it's so hot today.
For
around here, like 80 to 80 with humidity is like brutal. I'm sure this is probably nothing for you guys.
No, it depends because we're pretty dry out here.
Yeah, last week when I was in
so muggy,
so humid, and I couldn't take it. I'm used to that dry heat, man.
It was, I think Tuesday was 102, and then Wednesday, Thursday, Friday was 104.
Damn.
Yeah.
Yesterday, I think it got up to 110.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was still like 100 at like 9 or 10 last night.
Yeah. You know, Now that dry heat is just like, it's legit like an oven. Like, just turn on the oven and stick your head in there, and that's what it's like, man.
Yeah.
The second you walk outside.
You see, you know those, the heat waves or whatever, when everything looks wiggly? That's just everything you see.
That's permavision living out there.
Yeah. I don't have AC in my car either. That's why I had to stop off after picking up the exclusives. I was like, I can't make it back home in this heat. It's past noon.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
I was like, come inside for a little bit. Your cheeks are all rosy, man.
I crawled through the door. Thanks.
Yeah. Like that episode where SpongeBob's like dry as fuck.
Yeah. That was me. He showed me the exclusive. I need it.
Hey, Josh, so you got those naked turtles. How's that shit?
They're like hit and miss. Like, the turtles are like pretty good, and the foot soldier and the shredder like would be perfect if they had a damn ab crunch. Like,
Not the shredder doesn't even have anything.
No, man.
Ooh,
like, they would be perfect if they had a damn ab crunch. Like, I'm literally holding the shredder right now.
And it's just one solid piece from the shoulders to the waist. Just one solid.
Yep. It's got like a waist swivel, but no ab crunch. Like, it's got like, you know, double hinge elbows.
I totally overlooked that. I didn't even think of that.
It's got it's even got like toe joints too.
Damn.
It's a pretty decent ankle pivot, double hinge knees, ball joints on the hips, the heads. All you can get them all to look up. Like, Shredder even looks up pretty far.
Yeah, because the turtles, I was like, about the turtles, but, like, I really wanted the foot soldiers and Shredder. But, yeah, that's a damn shame there's nothing like that.
Yeah, it is.
Dude, it literally, like, it's so close to being just, like, perfect. Like, it's such, it's aggravating, really.
I want to know how you got all that Soda Street Fighter collection you got, Josh.
It's been a long process, man. long process.
I assume you started collecting those from the jump when they first came out, right?
Yeah, I picked up like all the player ones like right as they came out. Like, I got all the player ones like right off the bat, and then going back, like, I don't know why I came up with the idea, but I was like, I want to get all of them. So then, that was a stupid idea. And so I think I'm literally missing, like, maybe, like, five.
Oh, I thought you were only missing, like, two.
Well,
five, just right there, man. Think of how many there is.
Yeah. Like, I've got, I think I'm missing, like, one Fei Long, one Akuma. I'm missing, like, the Bloody Ryu and Sagat 2-pack. And I think, like, one or two more, and that's not if you count like the employee exclusive clear ones. Yeah, I don't have any of those, but
those are whack.
Yeah,
casual.
Yeah, you want that clear shit? That, you know that shit's going to break. You'd do anything with that.
Yeah.
Fuck, dude, clear plastic mixed with, like, sometimes the sodas get a little fucked up.
And that's the other thing, too, man. They break so damn easily. Like, you really got to be careful.
I've seen John Connor. He's got a tub just full of fucking shattered E-Hondas.
Oh, dude, well, that's when they, like, redid the, like, pretty much when they sold it off to, like, the new company, when the new company took over, and they, like, just used shitty plastic, and, like, I think I've gone through two E-Hondas myself, like, they just, it's just shit plastic, and they're so brittle. So, so brittle.
Nah, I seen Josh throwing it around the room, like, Hadouken!
Well, come on, man, how is he supposed to play with them things?
Right. Get Ernie to join in. I see.
Hey, what does Ryu say when he does that spinning kick?
Oh man!
I try to get everybody to always do it.
Shit.
It took me a minute to think about that.
Do it again. Yeah. I missed it. I was talking.
I don't know.
Ah, come on! You're gonna make me wait 2 weeks.
It's not a Tatsu Maki?
No, that's it's Sapaktu something. That's what it is, I think.
Brianna's brother, he can do it, like, really good. Like, that's on call. He, like, knows what he says, and he can do it, like, really good. So we'd be playing, I'm like, hey, how do I do the spinning kick thing? Oh, yeah, how does he say it again? And like I get him to say it a couple times, and he's like, "Dude, he's like, I know what you're trying to do. You're trying to get me to keep saying it."
Knock it off already. Just knock it off.
I'd want to play Street Fighter with him just so I can get him to say it. But hey, man, you want to play Nintendo? Yeah, I put in Street Fighter. Hey, what's he say again?
Oh, man.
Damn it.
Is it the Tatsumaki Senpu Kyaku?
Yeah. I just looked it up.
I tried looking it up too. I'm like, fuck.
What the hell is that shit called?
I think it's down. If you say it like there's something that it kind of sounds like that he says that's like totally like doesn't even make sense. But if you say it like that, it sounds like perfect.
Yeah, it all just sounds like yelling to me.
Spaghetti and meatballs.
Tatsu Pakti, that you can.
How old are you, Muhammad?
34. Yeah, just turned 34 a month ago.
Nice. All right.
There as well.
The same age, Josh?
Got that.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
And I got a 2-year-old daughter.
Oh, yeah.
Nice.
Josh is in between us old guys and these young punks.
Yeah.
Got somebody to mediate when the 90s discussions start.
Yeah.
Start translating.
Exactly. He can translate for me and Diego.
Yeah.
That 90s talk comes in. That's when Todd's like, "All right, I'll be back."
Yeah. Take your Furbies and go.
Come on, Furby. That wannabe fucking Mogwai shit, get that shit out of here.
Damn.
Taking Pokemon and shove them in your butt.
Yeah. Who else is going to keep my Beanie Babies company?
Beanie Babies and your Pokemons.
Once all your Funko Pops degrade, the Beanie Babies will reign supreme.
Yeah. They'll make it.
I was ransom kid over earlier playing Pokemon.
Little kid, get out of the street. I know you're playing that Pokemon.
give him a stern finger wagging.
Yeah, oh yeah. I shook my fist at him. You damn whippersnapper.
Get out of here with them damn that Pokemon.
That's Pokemon, isn't it?
You and your Dragon Z Balls and your Pokemon.
Yeah.
Damn, Pokemon's out too. What?
Go read a newspaper.
Man, Josh's favorite anime is King of the Hill.
Hey, I love that show.
King of the Hill.
Oh, speaking of which, this is going to make me sound old. MTV is starting a new channel.
I saw that.
Yeah. They're bringing Beavis and Butthead back, I think.
And Daria, yeah. And the Aeon Flux.
Oh, that's kind of cool.
Hey, you guys remember the show The Head Saves the Earth or The Head Saves the World or something?
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Yeah, you remember that shit on MTV? Yeah. That dude, that giant-ass head that had that like, demon fucking alien living in it? And there was like that dude with like the fucking the lawnmower blade stuck in his face and shit. And there's like the whole group of like those random like mutants.
Yeah, I missed that one.
It was one of those ones that maybe had like 12 episodes tops.
Yeah, like the Max and all those other series.
Yeah.
I love that Max cartoon. That shit was so bad.
I only liked it because it was based on the comic.
Yeah. I got excited when they said MTV is going to start a new channel. I was like, oh my god, they're going to play videos again?
Well, did you read that on the day it launches, the first hour, they're going to go back and replay the first hour of when MTV first started?
That would be cool.
Well, that's tight.
So Todd's, you can see all those old videos.
Todd's like, I could finally see Take On Me again.
I know the first video that they played.
Yeah, well, that's Video Killed the Radio Star.
That's right.
The Buggles?
The Buggles, yeah.
Fun fact
for you whippersnappers.
I didn't have MTV, but my buddy, best friend next door did, and we just loved that shit.
I used to watch MTV, like, all the time.
And it had almost no commercials. Like, at the beginning, they were just playing, like, commercials for the channel.
Yeah, oh, tell your cable provider, I want my MTV.
Yeah.
You think Kurt Loder's still alive or what?
I know.
Dude, that guy was old as shit back in the 90s, man.
I was shocked Kirk Douglas is still alive. He's going to turn 100.
Wow. Damn, Spartacus?
Yep,
Spartacus is still kicking?
Apparently, yeah. He's,
God damn, dude, he's got to look fucking gnarly as shit, because Michael Douglas looks pretty fucking gnarly.
Yeah, I can't remember what... He's got...
Oh, God. Yeah, I just looked him up, and it's like Michael Douglas kissing the Crypt Keeper, man. Wow.
It's like Mr. Burns and Smithers, bro.
I mean, I don't want to be mean, you know, the guy, you know, hey, kudos to him for making it that long, but Jesus, these pictures are not flattering. Dude, that's his eyes are all cockeyed, man.
Oh, damn.
Jeez. Oh, God, this one's worse. It's him.
Oh, shit, dude, yeah, man. He doesn't
Michael
have...
Doug-
It's a bummer he doesn't have that powdered toast man chin anymore, dude. Actually, he kind of does a little bit. A little powdered toast man still peeking in there.
Oh, man. I feel like the real Kirk Douglas is underneath there and his mask is like falling off or something.
Fucking Ren and Stimpy callback. I love it.
Yeah.
Dude, Ren and Stimpy's the shit, dude. That shit was like the gnarliest cart. Have you ever guys watched the Ren and Stimpy? Like there's like an unrated one.
Yeah.
Have you seen those? Those are fucking savage, dude.
Yeah.
You thought regular Ren and Stimpy was savage? This shit is fucking another level.
Yeah, that was, and that's where Beavis and Butthead started. It was a Spike and Mike's Twisted Festival of Animation, and I saw that in Austin, Texas. It was like, I don't know, one of the first years that they did it. And, all those cool cartoons, a lot of them spawned from that.
When the Blockbuster here was closing, Marie got that uncut Ren and Stimpy set.
Nice.
Yeah, that was sick.
John Chris Felucci, man, that guy's awesome.
They used to do those close-ups on things, like the hairballs or like Snippy's foot, like that. That.
Oh yeah. Disgusting. Or the teeth. You're just like, fuck.
Yeah.
Hell yeah, dude.
Oh, it's so nasty. It was drawn so well and it was so detailed. Yeah. Like, I would always get so queasy when I was a kid. I'm like, yeah, that's fucking nasty.
Hey, like you gotta take a shower after you sit through an episode.
And yeah. If you're eating, like, you can't be eating when you're watching that shit. You're just like, ooh.
Cereal, yeah.
Yeah, breakfast had to wait till after Ren and Stimpy.
Yeah, you look at your cereal and you're just like, nah, dude.
Do you guys ever play the video game?
Which one?
They
had, like, 3 Super Nintendo games.
I don't know, I played it on Sega Genesis.
Yeah, I played that one, like, briefly.
Because there's one where they're firefighters, like the firefighter dog ones, and then can't remember the other one that I have. It's like where you're mobbing through the house and shit.
I think it was that one.
Yeah. Where you're like in the kitchen and shit.
Yeah, and you have to go through the freezer or something.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was horrible at that.
See, I got a bunch of those Ren and Stimpy comics, man. Those things are tight. I think they're made by Marvel, right?
Yeah.
They were put out by Marvel?
No, they were put out by Marvel.
Yeah.
There was a fantastic show that John Kay only did on the internet after Ren and Stimpy closed shop, or he sold it to Nickelodeon or whatever. It was called the Goddamn George Licker Program. And that shit is fucking hilarious if you can find it. He had like a like mentally disabled nephew that lived with him or something. Oh my god! It's just crazy.
Dang.
He's just like his old crazy drunk redneck guy. It's fucked up.
So I was like, I don't want any of your Pokemon crap. I want to see all this fucked up cartoon.
Fucked up cartoons.
That's right. I miss Super Jail.
Yeah, dude.
Super Jail.
I only caught a little bit of that because I don't got cable, but I'd go to my friend's house and watch that shit. I'm like, yo, man, this shit's tight, man. How savage that shit is.
Dude, I'll have to burn you a DVD, man. Fucking
Super Jail. Yeah, Todd, if you like savageness like that, then you'll definitely like the humans.
Oh, yeah. That's why I'm excited. I was like, I finally need to put those on my tablet so I can start reading those at night.
I didn't know you got down like that, Todd.
Dang.
I'm all about savagery.
Dang, I should give you my savage hat then.
Well, my birthday is coming up.
Oh, there you go. Get one custom made.
No, I don't really rock hats. I wear.
Well, now you do.
Now you do.
I wear a boonie hat at work. I should have been wearing it much sooner.
What's that? Like a straw hat? You're rocking around a little cart with a little horn singing elotes, elotes.
No, it's like what you were in a jungle on patrol in the army.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Or Navy SEALs. Yeah, it's, you know, they got the brim. It's like a small sombrero.
Gotcha.
Oh man, Ren and Stimpy number 6 is The Amazing Spider-Man versus Powdered Toast Man. How did I miss that?
They have a bunch of Powdered Toast Man ones. I got that issue.
Yeah.
Powdered Toast Man's the shit, dude. That's like, if I could cosplay, like make my own costume, dude, I'd definitely do Powdered Toast Man. I haven't seen anybody tackle that one yet.
Sick. Oh, and then you and Michael can fight each other because Michael's
Spider-Man.
Yeah. What? Oh, did you hear the Tick is coming back?
Yeah.
Yeah, Tick's all right.
Yeah, Tick was cool.
Yeah, I love Patrick Warburton, but even then I wasn't a big of a fan of this show.
So you guys want to wrap it up?
Sure.
Better wrap that shit up, B.
Just about 2 a.m. here.
Damn. All right, time for Ren and Stimpy.
Yeah, dude. There you go.
Yeah, now it's the good time.
Hey, real quick, do you guys remember that video by, there's a group called like Green Jello, and they did like the little pigs, like the...
Yep.
Little pig.
Yeah, dude, that fucking music video, yeah. That's like one of the first things I remember watching it, because I was really young, like MTV, well, I was born in the late 80s, so like my mom like the only one let me watch MTV when she was like around, because sometimes there should be like savage shit, but I'd wake up all early and I'd watch shit, and I remember seeing that one, and that was like, that one did it for me. I was like, dude, yes.
Punker Mike was born.
Yes.
Yeah, dude. That's where the savagery grew.
Yeah, warped your young mind.
Yeah, especially that part, and then came Rambo. I'm like, oh, shit, Rambo, dude.
I was actually singing that the other day when my brothers were over here, and them and Marie were making fun of me. They're like, what the fuck are you singing? And I was like, you guys never heard that? Yeah. Maximum Carnage Band, man.
Yeah, me and Punker Mike both love Venture Brothers, and so I got him that Venture Brothers figure for his birthday.
Dr. Girlfriend.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You guys just started watching the show.
It's all about Molotov Cocktails is the other one I want to get, too.
Yeah, she's hot. I love the early episodes where Brock Sampson is just fucking murdering dudes with a machete.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah.
God, those are the best. All right, Muhammad, well, thanks so much for coming on with us.
Yeah, no, guys, thanks for having me on. I appreciate it. It was a blast.
First time's free.
What's your Instagram handle?
DarkRider1463S. Lowercase s. I've had that screen name for the longest time. Like one of my cousins the other day, she's like, "Yeah, you know, that sounds like a fucked up porn star name." I was like, "You know, it might be time to get rid of Dark Rider."
You know, it was a dark time in my life. That's your YouTube name, right?
Yeah, that's what I have everywhere. YouTube, Xbox. Instagram.
Pornhub.
yeah, exactly. My other job. I made it up a long time ago when I was playing Dungeons and Dragons with my cousin. And it just kind of stuck.
Even better.
Yeah, I played Dungeons and Dragons back in the day.
Yo, I played D&D too.
Back in the day, man, a week ago.
Yeah.
All right, man. We'll, hopefully we will see more. Are you going to enter the world tournament?
Yes, sir. I didn't get to do photo combat this year. I was a judge, but I didn't get to participate. But yeah, coming up for the next world tournament, I'm definitely going to enter this year. I dropped the ball last year in the third round. I'm not making the same stupid mistakes again. I'm going to make all new ones.
We'll triple see you later.
What's your shit?
Hi, guys. Yeah, this...
triple see you later.
It was real, guys. I appreciate being on.
All right. Have a good night.
Yeah, you guys as well.